from a dynasty to a team that hasn't won a playoff game in 14 years. Welcome to the big time, right? Hi there, Lauren Shahadi here, bringing you your daily sports update presented by Toyota. Scott Pioli set to replace Carl Peterson as the Kansas City Chiefs' new general manager. Pioli became vice president of player personnel for the Patriots in 2002. Now he moves on to the Chiefs, where he will have complete charge of football operations. As for the fate of Coach Herm Edwards and his staff, that is not immediately known. What Jim Caldwell wants to make known is that he is not Tony Dungy's identical twin, that he wants to build on the success of Dungy, and that the Indianapolis Colts are now very much his team. Caldwell replaces Dungy as head coach after he announced his retirement. Caldwell takes over a team that has been to the playoffs 7 straight seasons, won at least 12 games in 6 consecutive seasons, and has won 5 of the last 6 AFC South titles. Tough act to follow, right? Well, perhaps you'll want to follow the careers of these guys. Michael Crabtree, ever heard of him? Crabtree decided his duty on the college football field is done. 2 years of college football, 2 years of being chosen the best receiver in the country. He is out. Ball State's Nate Davis will take his 26 touchdowns, 8 interceptions to the league next season. And All-American defensive end Aaron Maven will skip his final 2 seasons at Penn State and declare for the NFL draft. Someone who doesn't have their eyes on the NFL, Frank Spaziani. And that was extremely important when deciding who to follow Jeff Jagosinski as the head coach of Boston College. Spaziani stayed at BC, even though he was disappointed when he was passed over for the head coaching job in 2006. The loyalty, it paid off after Jagosinski was fired last week after he interviewed with the New York Jets. To the hard court we go. The Cleveland Cavaliers are injured. LeBron James is not. In fact, he was the only healthy front court player for the Cavs, but he was much more than that on Tuesday night against Memphis. James dropped 30 points, 11 boards, 10 assists, quite a resume for his second triple-double of the season, leading the Cavs to a 102-87 victory over the Grizzlies. With Big Z sidelined with a fractured left ankle and Ben Wallace out with a flu, Cleveland was missing 40% of its starting lineup. How about another stud for you, Kobe, dropping 33 on the Rockets, doing it all while wearing a bandage over his right eye after getting cut and having stitches for a head-to-head collision with D-Wade on Sunday. Jody Meeks had many hoop dreams of scoring a school record 54 points to help Kentucky cruise to a 90-72 win over number 24 Tennessee on Tuesday night was a reality. He broke Dan Issel's 39-year-old record of 53 points set at Mississippi, and after he was completely mobbed by his Kentucky teammates in the middle of the court, where the Wildcats, who are 2-0 in the SEC, handed the Volunteers their third loss in January. Movement in January on the diamond, and in the words of John Smoltz, the uniform has changed, the desire has not. After playing all 20 of his major league seasons with the Atlanta Braves, Smoltz, the only pitcher in baseball history with 200 wins, 150 saves, is starting over at 41 with the Red Sox. The righty says he is doing great after his shoulder surgery. He finalized a 1-year, $5.5 million agreement on Tuesday. So who will take his place in the ATL? A guy from L.A. I'm talking Derek Lowe. Lowe's 4-year stint with the Dodgers is about to end. He won 14 games last year, averaged more than 200 innings in 4 seasons in L.A. and has agreed to a $60 million deal with Atlanta. Lowe anchored an inexperienced rotation last season, was the club's number one pitcher in the playoffs. He was 14-11 with a 3.24 ERA. Well, that is your sports update for Wednesday. I will be here tomorrow, will you? Hope so.